The next topic is crystal oscillators. So the crystal is a thin slice of piezoelectric material. Example of piezoelectric material is such as quartz, tourmaline, and rocklet salt, which exhibit a property called piezoelectric effect. Okay, so crystal oscillator is nothing but a piezoelectric material. So for example of piezoelectric material is quartz, tourmaline, and rocklet salt. So which material exhibits the property called piezoelectric effect? Okay, so let's see what is meant by piezoelectric effect. So the piezoelectric crystal is placed on a two parallel plate, placed between the two metal plates, right, under the balanced condition. So it does not produce any electric current in this material. So now we apply the mechanical force to these two metal plates, which forces the electric current in that crystal material. That property is called as a piezoelectric property. So which defined in the definition of, when an AC voltage is applied across a quartz crystal, it vibrates at the frequency of applied voltages. Conversely, if a mechanical force is applied to vibrate a quartz crystal, it generates an AC voltage, right? So initially we applied AC voltage, it does not produce any charge, right? But when we apply the mechanical force to this crystal, that is to the metal plate, it generates an AC voltage, that is the electric charge, electric current in that material. This effect is called as the piezoelectric effect. So the crystal oscillators are widely used in communication transmitters, digital watches, and clock, etc. The main substances exhibiting the piezoelectric effects are quartz, rocklet salt, and tourmaline. So these are the material we are using a crystal oscillators, because which one, these materials only exhibits the piezoelectric effect. So let's see one by one. Rocklet salt have the greatest piezoelectric activity. It is mechanically weakest of the three, that is three means rocklet salt, tourmaline, and quartz. When compare these other two, which exhibits a weakest, mechanically weakest, and break very easily. Then second one is tourmaline shows least piezoelectric effect, but the mechanically strongest, most expensive, rare in practice. Then quartz is a compromise between the above two, that is piezoelectric activity of above two. It is inexpensive and easily available in nature. So that's why we are maximum using an quartz in the crystal oscillators. So let's see the quartz crystal constructions. So the nature shape of the quartz crystal is a hexagonal prism, but in a practical use it cut into a rectangular slab which is mounted between two metal plates. So practically, which is cut in a rectangular slab mounted between two metal plates. So there are two methods available to cut the hexagonal prism into rectangular shape, which determines the natural resonant frequency and temperature coefficient of the crystal. So based on the cutting method, we have to determine the natural resonance frequency as well as the temperature coefficient. So this is the hexagonal prism. There are two methods. One is X-cut method, another one is Y-cut method. So for X-cut method, wafer is cut in such a way that it flat surfaces are perpendicular to its electrical axis. Meanwhile, the Y-cut method is the flat surfaces are perpendicular to the mechanical axis, that is Y-axis. So these are the two methods for cutting in a quartz crystal from hexagonal prism into rectangular, right? So next one is electrical equivalent circuits of crystal. So this is the electrical equivalent circuit of crystal. So crystal is nothing but it consists of RLC component with parallel with mounted capacitance. This is the frequency response curve. It consists of a series RLC circuit in parallel with the capacitance CP. When the crystal mounted across the AC source is not vibrating, so the crystal is mounted across the AC source is not vibrating, that is equivalent to CP, right? Crystal is vibrating. When the crystal is vibrating means equivalent to the tuned circuit RLC. So when the crystal is mounted across the AC source is not vibrating, but the crystal is vibrating, which is equivalent to the tuned circuit RLC. From the graph, the crystal has two closely spaced resonance frequency. One is series resonance frequency, another one is parallel resonance frequency. So series resonance frequency occurs the reactance of the L is equal to the reactance of the CS, right? So the series resistance frequency occur, the reactance of the L is equivalent to the reactance of the CS. So in that case, impedance of the equivalent circuit is equal to the resistance R, and F is given by, so series resistance frequency F is equal to 1 by 2 pi root LCS. Whereas in a parallel resistance frequency occur, the reactance of RLC is equivalent to the CP. So series resistance frequency la, the reactance of L is equivalent to the CS, but in a parallel, the reactance of RLC is equal to the mounting capacitance. So FB is equal to 1 by 2 pi root of L C equivalent, where C equivalent is CS CP divided by CS plus CP, because CS and CP is a parallel. CP less than, greater than CS, then we neglect this CP. So C equivalent equal to CS, hence FS equal to FP. So C equivalent equal to CS means FS equal to FP. So the crystal has a very high value of Q factor, that value is 20,000. So the high values of the Q factor of a crystal produces oscillator with very stable frequency value. So the Q factor Q equal to omega L by R. So the high value of Q factors of a crystal produces oscillator with very stable frequency values. That is omega is equal to 2 pi F. Very stable frequency values. Next one, Pierce crystal oscillators. So this is the circuit diagram of Pierce crystal. The crystal is connected as a series element in a feedback path from the collector to base terminal. R1, R2 and RE. R1, R2, RE, which are the DC biases to the transistor, and CE is a bypass capacitor. RF is a choke, which is used for DC biasing while decoupling any AC signal on the power lines from affecting the output signals. So the coupling capacitor, C blocks any DC between collector to base. That is, the coupling capacitor C blocks any DC voltage between the collector to base and has negligible impedance at the operating frequency of the oscillators. So this is also called as the series resistance crystal oscillator, so that the crystal impedance is the smallest and the amount of feedback is the largest. So crystal impedance is smallest means the amount of feedback is the largest. Okay. So therefore, the resulting circuit frequency of oscillation is set by the series resistance frequency of the crystal is given by F is equal to 1 by 2 pi root of LCS. So in a Pierce crystal oscillators, the series resonance, the frequency value is equivalent to the series resonance frequency, that is 1 by 2 pi root LCS. Next one is Miller's crystal oscillators. So this is the circuit diagram of Miller's crystal oscillator. The Hartley oscillator circuits can be modified to get the Miller crystal oscillator. In Hartley, two inductors and one capacitor is required in the tank circuit. One inductor is replaced by the crystal, which act as a inductor for the frequency slightly greater than the series resonance frequency. So in Hartley oscillators, the one inductor is replaced, modified by as a crystal, which act as an inductor for the frequency which is slightly greater than the series resonance frequency, right? The tuned circuit of L and C is of tuned to behave as an L, so which act as an L. So the crystal behaves as another inductance between gate and ground. So the crystal behaves as a another inductor between the gate and ground. So this is ground, this is gate. Okay. The internal capacitance act as a, the internal capacitance act as a capacitor. That is, this internal capacitance, the dotted line mentioned the internal, which act as a capacitor required to fulfill the element in a tank circuit, because this one act as a completely L. So this internal capacitance act as a capacitor, so the complete set satisfy the tank circuit. So for A beta greater than equal to 1, X1 cannot be too small. Hence the circuit will oscillate at a frequency which lies between WS and WB, but close to the parallel frequency. Okay. So if for A big greater than 1 means that the X1 cannot be too small, because that AB value is greater, so it can't possible too small. So hence the circuit will oscillate at a frequency which lies between the WS and WP, so it become a parallel resonance frequency. Since WP approximately equal to WS, the oscillator frequency is essentially determined by the crystal and not by the rest of the circuit. So from that, the Pierce crystal frequency is equivalent to the series frequency, and the Miller crystal oscillator's frequency is equal to the parallel resonance frequency. right? Next one, frequency stability of oscillator. The frequency stability of an oscillator is a measure of its ability to maintain the required frequency as possible over the long time interval. So frequency stability of oscillator means we have to maintain the frequency stable at a long time interval. So the main drawback in a transistor oscillator is that the frequency of oscillation is not stable during a longer time operations. So it's not possible in practical for long time to maintain the stable frequency. So then how it will possible? Let's see one by one. The following factors are the reason for change in frequency. So the temperature, then variation in the power supply, unstable transistor parameter and aging factor. And third one is the effective resistance of the tank circuit is changed when the load is connected. Last one is due to variation in biasing condition and loading conditions. So these are the four factors which is the reason for not stable in a frequency for a long period. Okay. So the variation of frequency with the temperature is given by SW temperature del omega by omega naught divided by del D by T naught parts per million per seconds. So omega naught is a desired frequency of oscillations to operating the temperatures. So in the absence of automatic temperature control, the effect of temperature on the tank circuit can be reduced by selecting an inductance L with positive temperature coefficient and an AC with negative temperature coefficients. Okay. So these are the four reasons for not maintaining the frequency at stable at long period. So first factor is temperatures. So if the frequency is varied with the temperature, means we can define that stability factor is S equal to del omega by omega naught divided by del T by T naught. So here omega naught is the desired frequency of oscillations to operate the temperatures. So the absence of automatic temperature control. So the absence of automatic temperature control, the effect of temperature on the tank circuits can be reduced, right? So the automatic temperature is absence means the effect of tank circuits can be reduced by selecting an inductance L. So L with the positive temperature coefficient and C with the negative temperature coefficients. So here you have to remember that in the absence of temperature, the tank circuit can't be reducing the temperature of tank circuits can be reduced, right? So at that time the inductance will with the positive temperature coefficient and capacitors with negative temperature coefficients. So at that time the frequency of stability is defined as SW equal to T theta by T omega. So theta is a phase shift. The circuit giving a larger value of T theta by T omega has the most stable oscillator frequency. So this is the condition for maintaining the oscillating frequency stable for a long period in terms of the temperatures coefficient. Okay. So that's all about the stability of the feedback oscillator, crystal oscillator.